Ken Bianco from Trainworx TV, and today we're going to take you inside a sneak peek of the model train layout in Grand Central Station, built by Trainworx by Roger Farkash. And this is very exciting because it's probably one of the coolest layouts I've seen. He just built a masterpiece. So stay tuned and watch inside. Thank you.
Hey, good morning. This is Roger Farkash with TW Trainworx. We're out of Dallas, Texas, but today we're in New York City setting up the Grand Central Terminal display, the holiday display, and this is the year number 12 that the holiday display has gone in. We bring the display in every year in November. This year it'll be opening November 16th and run into February. The display is about 32 feet by 7 feet. It's basically a bean-shaped units, three bean-shaped units. It's all modular. We build the base in sections that just hinge together. The tabletop set on top of that, bolt together. And in about 8 hours, we've got it all set up and running trains. So it's a lot of fun, a great opportunity to be back here in the city. And appreciate Kenny inviting us down here to do the Train World video. Good stuff. Display arrives in six wooden crates. They're all caster. They weigh up to 1,600 pounds, the heaviest crate. So it's a pretty substantial amount of scenery. The first crate that we set in has the base units in, and we'll step inside and show you that. But everything actually has a specific slot for it to sit in, and it's all taken out in sequence. Everything is labeled and numbered. So we've only been at it now for 2 hours, and we've got the whole base in and the number of the, almost all the tabletops. So we'll step inside and take a look. All of the tabletops, and actually all the parts of the setup and the display, again, right in these crates, and you can see there, tabletops actually just slide right in. We have a rope that we tie through these holes that holds the plexiglass in. It helps us drag it out the first night. But that's all it takes to slide the whole display. And they're different sizes depending on what's on top of the tabletop. In 2005, Lionel came to TW Trainworx, asked us to build a display that they could have yearly in the Grand Central Terminal. They came to us in August, we started work in September, we delivered it in November. It was a really fast process, but pretty exciting to get all this built in a short amount of time and get it in here into the terminal, where now this is year number 12, so pretty exciting stuff. It takes about a crew of six to put the layout together. We have basically a 12-hour day to do it in. It's trucked in on a box truck that, it's in six crates. And everything that we need is in those six crates to set up the display and get it operating. We have a 12-hour day because 8 hours to set it up, and then at 8 o'clock p.m., the truck comes back to pick up the empty crates, put them into storage, because there's not enough room here in the museum to actually keep the crates as well. They'll come back in February when we take them down. This shot that we're setting up here actually gives you the full spectrum of what it takes to assemble the unit. Basically, we drop our transformer control panel down on the ground and then place all of our gates on the ground around it. These just hinge together. And you can see our tabletops are all drilled for bolts and also for running wires through, wire chases. We have units that bridge the gaps that we leave in the table between the fast track on either side of the table. And then they essentially, slide them together, bolt them together until we have our entire train layout. All right, we have just a couple more of the tabletops to slide together here. But as you can see, tabletops in terms of the cityscape, it's a little bit vacant right now, but we do have our concrete pads. We also have our terminal blocks and or plugs that we have RCA type jacks. that we use for electrifying the different buildings that are located on the tabletops. Everything is numbered and labeled so we know what goes where. And we'll be putting the table or the buildings on top of the tables real quick here. Yeah, one of the really nice things about Fast Track using this kind of application where having to bring the whole set together quickly is the way Fast Track is embedded in that plastic. With just a little bit of alignment, we're able to slice together and have good contact and have trains running real quick. Before LEDs really became popular and affordable and multiple strips, neon tubes were real popular for lighting around your computer work area or whatever, and you'd have a, just plug this into a USB port and you could light up neon tubes in cars even too, like, you know, for when you're tricking out your hot rod, that kind of thing. But we found that using a computer power pack within our display, we were able to incorporate these neon tubes and we were able to illuminate all of our very large buildings very quickly, very simply, and very brightly too. So this is, I'm about to put this into the next building that we're gonna set on the table here. So until I get the building here, next shot. So if you recall, I was talking about how short a construction period we had to do this entire display. So we had to look for very simple ways to construct really large buildings. And the easiest way that we found was to simply take plexiglass, mask off areas that we were going to keep clear for windows, and then paint the rest of the surface our building colors. So on this particular layout, you'll see a lot of bulk in terms of buildings that are very simply constructed. It's plexiglass boxes with the light bars inside and then clear or frosted areas that we left for the windows. And that's the bulk of what we have on the table.
How long did it take you to learn how to create these buildings and sculpt them?
You know, this is a trick that I've used for many, many years in the theatrical end of our business. So when we would do simple background models for even in films, we'd do a cityscape that needed to have ability to turn lights on and off, that kind of thing. They wanted a little bit more dimensional look, depending on where the cameras were set up in the studio. We would do simple boxes like this. So
Is that how Trainworx came about, through the theater and then switching over to Trainworx?
The TW of TW Trainworx, TW Design, is Theatrical Warehouse. That's really how we started in business, is doing sets for scenery, for stage shows, operas, ballets, musicals, movies. Got very quickly into corporate events, displays for trade show booths. Commercials, restaurants, it just really expanded into a lot of different areas. But the basis for all that was our theatrical background, Theatrical Warehouse, where we used to do the whole thing, sets, lights, sound, wardrobe, really anything that you wanted. Eventually we scaled back and it's in really the scenery side. And obviously the TW Trainworx is the train displays. Large formats that we do for museums. Offshoot from the museum work we did as Theatrical Warehouse.
No job too small.
No job too small, no job too big. It was really anything that was three-dimensional that was baffling somebody. I have this idea, I want to do this on a sales meeting, a corporate event. They would come in and say, I need a telephone, but it's got to be 22 feet wide, you know? Yeah, we could do that. We even built a mock-up of an F-16 for the president and CEO of Dr. Pepper. He actually, the curtain opened on a giant airplane hangar, the airplane doors, hangar doors opened up, and this F-16 rolls onto the stage. They roll up a step case, and the CEO steps out with an F-16, so some very wild stuff. It's been pretty cool.
How'd you get into trains?
Oh, man. That story goes back to when I was 3 years old. We lived in Cincinnati, and in our backyard, literally, there was a ravine. At the bottom of the ravine was an industrial spur, and they were still running steam switchers through that spur. That when we moved into that house, now mind you, there was no fence. I mean, the yard went to the back, went down a hill, there was the train, and I was 3 years old. My mom said when I would hear the whistle blowing on the steam engine because they went under an overpass, I would run out the back door and run to the edge of the yard, and she'd go chasing me, but I never went to the edge because I was afraid of my dad's belt more than I was, getting into, more than getting out of that, in that ravine. But when the engineer or the fireman would see me, they'd poke each other, ring the bell, pull the whistle. I fell in love with trains. And my dad bought me a little wind-up Marx that year. So it was 1953, 54, so pretty cool stuff.
Okay, essentially what we did is take the Lionel highway lamppost, put an RCA jack in the bottom, and we have a jack, a female, corresponding female embedded into the wood. And once we have the whole tabletop and buildings in place, these are the last things we just poke those in to where they're gonna be. Neat thing about this is if we wanted to change time periods, you know, that's at the fourth dimension, right? We want to change time, we could do the same thing with an antique street light and just change them out. Put the antique street light, change them out to a modern, change a few buildings, have a different look on the same layout. One of the other ways we do connections when we don't have the luxury of putting the RCA jacks in the bottom, but still making it so that we can work from the top side, is we put these small terminal blocks, Euro block type connectors on the tabletop, because that's still a low profile for stacking it into the crates, but allows us to, again, interchange different buildings to fit on top of the layout and be connected as we're installing them.
Actually, it's all fun. Even the designing part, the whole process, talking to the client, finding out what their likes are, what their needs are, what the limitations are, parameters, finding ways to make huge things fit in small spaces. It's all a real challenge, but it is all a lot of fun. I enjoy doing the track plans. I enjoy doing the actual build with the guys in the shop. I'm more leaning, obviously, towards the carving side and the finish side in terms of the application of colors and or textures, finished pieces. But I've always enjoyed the process. I learned my craft from the backside forward. In other words, I learned how to build things before I started trying to design things. That way I would know that I knew if I could build it, that someone else, when they see my drawings, would be able to build it as well. So it's been a process, but it's a very enjoyable one, even to this day.
Do you hand draw them?
Oh, no, no. It's I used to, yes, but now it's all CAD.
Oh. Yeah. How'd you learn that?
Self-taught on the CAD.
Huh?
Yeah.
Take this and put this back over the back. There we go. As you can see, we've got a whole bank of transformers, and this is actually going to push more up into place like this. And there's a panel like this that'll cover over that during operation.
It's a lot of power.
Each one of them supplies power to a different shark section or a different lighting section. This is strictly lighting here. These are transformers for the subway tracks where the trains go back and forth. Look like they're coming and going. Here again is a connectors that tie together with the other one from the other table. Probably go through this way out here. our little hands don't get up in here and fiddle with any of it.
How long does it take you to hook up everything?
I hope we're done by 5 o'clock.
Wow.
We'll go along there. There's a lot going on over here. So what I've got to do is unwire all this stuff.
This is all pre-wired?
Yeah, in a sense. I have to unwire, I have to plug wires together and get it all plugged into the right spot so it'll do what it's supposed to do.
You have to be a masterful electrician with all these wires.
There's a, it takes a little understanding of what's going on to make it happen, for sure.
Wow.
I've been doing this for about 10 years plus, so.
Does it get easier as you get,
We've got harnesses over here, see? We're plugging these harnesses over here that I need to uncoil. Wow. Get those tied in. Same thing occurs from here to the back. This is my way to get there to the next table. So. That's where I'll be done. This is where I'll be the next 4 hours. These cut plugs like this, there's another plug right here. These plug together. And we have to do that all the way down, front to back. Huh? And some of this is, like you say, pre-wired to the sense you just, it's just a plug together thing. And then you've got some of it like this that's got to be wired in. That was never connectorized, if you want to call it that. So all these wires are color-coded to fit in these places here.
Need like a car roller to get around.
Well, in this case here, it's just as easy to slide around my back. And we build layouts for museums and individuals in their homes, and some of those are a little more extensive than this.
Right.
And I get on a furniture dolly with a pad on a lot of times, what I use.
Right. Very cool.
Anyways, that's what I'm fixing to do. This is going to be my dessert.
Well, thanks for showing us.
Yeah, and if we get the opportunity, if I see something interesting down there, we'll get down there and take a look at that.
Sounds cool.